Everybody, Laura Dragon here, and Miss Carranza. This is my mom's channel, not mine, but usually I would say that on my channel, not my mom's.
Anyway, thanks for the intro, Miss Laura Dragon. My daughter is here guest starring with me again today. We are going to be working on Chapter 4, Lesson 1, Triangle Classifications. You will need various writing utensils. You're going to see me using a lot of different colors today and different color highlighters. This is just to organize, so if you're not a very colorful person, that's okay, don't feel bad. It's not strictly needed. Looking at what we've done already, our most recent recording, our last recording was this one, the parallel lines and transversals. We looked at those different postulates and theorems. We had some examples, and in class we worked on some proofs, and so that's what you see here on the next couple of pages. The following page you will need to leave blank as a KWL for that particular lesson, the Chapter 3, Lesson 2 item. And our notes for today will start on the very next page. So go ahead and take a moment now, pause the video, and update it with today's lesson title and objectives. Laura Dragon, while I write my lesson objectives, will you read them for us today, please? They're here on the right-hand side of the screen, just under the La Feria logo.
Got it. So today, hey, wait, C4L1 stands for...
Chapter 4, Lesson 1.
That's what I was going to say. Triangle Classic... Chapter 4, Lesson 1, Triangle Classifications. What? I will classify triangles. That's what we're going to be doing today. How? That's how we're going to do it. I will identify angle types and congruent sizes. Correct, Mom?
Oops, I meant sides.
You put sizes.
I put sizes. Rip. Let me fix that. Hang on. There we go. I meant sides. Congruent sides.
Okay. So, actually, that says sides. Sorry, people watching out there.
Sorry.
So, triangle classifications. That's what we're going to be doing today.
All right. There it is. Let's go ahead and kick it off with our different types of classifications. We're going to classify triangles one of two ways. First, we will be doing it by angle, then we will be classifying them by sides. So we're going to write our first header is our classifications by angle. Our first angle classification is going to be the acute triangle. An acute triangle is a triangle in which all angles excuse me,
Mom,
still
it's running off.
Oh, I'm off the screen. I'm sorry. A triangle in which all angles are acute angles. If you don't recall what acute angles are, please recall back to angle classifications.
Shall we
I believe that was Chapter 1, Lesson 4A.
Mom? Shall we highlight all of our keywords?
Not today.
Why not?
Because they're off to the left-hand side. All right. Our next classification by angle, bless you,
sorry,
is going to be the right triangle.
May I draw you a right triangle?
Not yet. Mm-hmm. A right triangle is a triangle in which one and only one angle is a right angle. Again, if you do not recall what a right angle is, please recall yourself back to Chapter 1, Lesson 4A.
Mom, what's this little symbol thing?
That's our recall symbol. It's like it looks almost like the recycling symbol a little bit. Because we are recycling knowledge.
Got it.
The next triangle classification is the obtuse triangle. The obtuse triangle is a triangle in which one angle is an obtuse angle.
Did you make a class video on that?
Yes, I did. You'll want to recall to the video, Chapter 1, Lesson 4. I will put a link in the description for you.
So, yeah. If you who don't recall what an obtuse angle is, what was it? What was the word?
Recall.
Recall to... I'll pick that up, Mom.
Sorry, technical difficulties. Stuff fell off the side of my desk.
Yeah.
All right, we'll continue while Miss Laura Dragon helps me out.
That's why I'm here.
And picks those up for me. The next triangle type is the equiangular triangle. This triangle is called equiangular. An equiangular triangle is a triangle in which all angles are congruent. All right. Our next section of notes is going to be over classifications by sides. Not size.
Sides.
Our first triangle classification is the scalene triangle. That is pronounced scalene.
Mom, what's a scalene angle, triangle, whatever?
A scalene triangle is a triangle in which no sides
are congruent
to each other.
Oh, so basically it's all wonky.
Yeah, it's all kind of a wonkyish triangle. We'll draw some in just a bit. We want to get all of our definitions done first.
Correct.
Our next triangle classification by side is the isosceles triangle. This word is pronounced isosceles.
Is there such thing as an isosceles angle?
No. It is only the triangle that is isosceles.
Same with, what was the first one?
Scalene. An isosceles triangle is a triangle in which at least two sides are congruent.
So for you people watching out there, if you think I'm too interruptive, then I'm trying not to be.
Yeah, so you should stop talking. That helps.
Got it.
Yeah. Thank you. Our third and final side classification is the equilateral triangle. This word is pronounced equilateral.
I've heard of equilateral before.
Now, equilateral comes from two word parts. This first word part, equa, which means equal or the same.
And the second one is lateral,
which means side. For my Spanish speakers, think of lateral almost like lado, side. For my football players, a lateral pass is a pass thrown to the side. An equilateral triangle is a triangle in which all three sides are congruent to each other. All right, let's do one quick example of classifying by all the different types that we have here. Okay, so here we go. Going to grab just one of my little random boxes that I happen to have here. This is my bingo chip box, and I'm going to use it to the straight edge in order to draw a triangle. There we go. Here's a beautiful triangle, and I'm going to make some markings on this triangle. The first markings I'm going to make is I'm going to draw a little tiny hash mark in those lines. Please recall that these little hash marks mean that those things are congruent to each other.
So basically, it's like same shape side.
Right, so these two sides here are congruent to each other. And since I have two sides congruent to each other, this triangle is an isosceles triangle. And that's the sort of thing that you will look at when you are trying to classify your triangles. You look at the properties that you are given, and from there, you match it up to one of the seven different classifications listed above and use that to name your triangle. Always make sure that you include whatever angle classification or side classification word you're using and the word triangle. You'll need them both. And that'll do us for triangle classifications for today. We'll see you in class tomorrow, and have a great afternoon or evening or morning or whatever time of day it is when you were watching this video.
weren't you going to say I was going to draw the triangles?
Oops.
So, don't go out of the video just yet.
Well, I don't have any more space on my paper to draw triangles. You want to draw a triangle?
Yeah.
All right, go for it. Draw a triangle, my love.
This is probably going to be really...
Over here.
Oh, down here.
Yeah, down there, because I want to save this paper for something else. So draw
a
triangle there.
Sorry, people.
It's okay. Draw your triangle.
For some reason, I want to try to do it on an obtuse triangle.
Okay, try to draw
an obtuse. I don't know how to do it.
So we need to draw an obtuse angle. What is an obtuse angle? Do you remember? She's looking at the wall. I like it. You see the one that says obtuse angle? See, that's a big, fat, wide angle?
Yeah, they're like, woo.
Woo. Okay, so draw a big, fat, wide angle.
How do I do this?
Is that a big fat wide angle right there?
No.
No.
It's very much.
All right. So try again. All right. That is a beautiful triangle. I know it's a little on the blurry side, but there it is. There's Miss Allura Dragon's triangle. Thank you very much for watching, and we'll see you next time.
Goodbye.